Leaves and plants are nature's solar panels. The first step in photosynthesis is to change sunlight into a little bit of electricity that then gets converted into the processes of life. If we manage to somehow hijack the molecules that are responsible for photosynthesis in plants and other photosynthetic organisms and use them to generate electricity for our own needs, this would represent a fantastic and disruptive new step in the way that we generate solar power or electricity in general. So imagine if the raw material for a solar panel would be something that you normally think of as trash and you actually pay people to take away. Imagine that your grass clippings can become the active ingredient in a solar panel that you can create at your own home. The way that you would do it is take something green and extract the protein that is at the center of photosynthesis. That is not very hard. It's not as hard as it sounds anyway. The hard part is, once you've extracted this protein, how do you stabilize and how do you make sure that it still continues operating, continues living in a sense, inside of a solar panel, while normally it is used to living inside of a plant? Well, that is a problem that we have attacked here at the lab. After many years of research, we've managed to make the process of extracting this protein and stabilizing it and putting it on a surface that is made in a way that allows for a photovoltaic effect to happen to be very easy. So the dream is to eventually be able to send people just the stabilizing powder that is benign and inexpensive and entirely easy to work with and has a long shelf life and it doesn't mind being transported by truck over unimproved roads. And then all the people who would be interested in doing this have to do is find some kind of substrate, some kind of piece of metal, let's say this, or a piece of glass, and use any of the various protocols that we've described into making this a little rougher so it has a higher surface area so they can have more capturing more light and have higher efficiency. Soak it in the green goo that they've added the stabilizing peptides to, and that's basically it. After that, you can connect a couple of wires and charge a battery, use it to illuminate something. You've got electricity from the sunlight. And the idea is that because it is so, we've lowered the difficulty involved in making solar power, that we are going to allow crowds and one hopes thousands of people to try it and figure out what works for them and what local materials that they can find perhaps in their backyard or they can find it in the junkyard, what works for them to become not only consumers of electricity but also producers of electricity for themselves, and if they're really good at it, they can start selling it to others.